Hey folks, this is Best of Slot and welcome back to our Planet Zoo Southeast Asian build. In today's video, we're going to carry our cave on and we're going to build our clouded leopard habitat. And the idea for this is kind of an underground forested cave kind of shebang. That's the idea. So we're going to build up the cave, we're going to fill it with forest, and it's going to look cool. It's also going to be a pain in the ass. But we'll explain that as we get to it. So originally the idea for this, I had a very specific cave image in mind. I had this beautiful cave photograph that I found online, and I really wanted to recreate the basic feeling of that. And that was going to be that bigger area on the right-hand side. And initially I was going to have it so there's a little bit of a sort of forest on the left as well, and the leopards could cross over, but I figured we'll probably do something like that with the monkeys, and it was too much work. Basically, I wanted the left to be, I don't know, I didn't want to draw focus away from the right hand side, which I had like a very specific image in mind that I really wanted to get to, so I didn't want to pull attention away from that. Now, this was a tough thing to kind of kickstart off, you know, especially when you're trying to build something very, very particular. And the cave walls, I don't know why I keep using the rocks. You'll see in a second, we're going to get rid of it. We're basically going to do this, yeah. I realized at this point that although the last time we did a big cave, you know, in the caiman exhibit during our aquatic park, that cave ended up looking really good. But as soon as I started the build with these rocks, I just thought, this is not going to work. This is not going to look like I want it to look. So why don't we just go back to using terrain tools like we used to do in the good old days? So we're basically going to get rid of most of the fake rocks, and we're going to construct the entire cave out of terrain tools, and we're going to dig into it and break it up and all that kind of jazz. Now, my first mistake was trying to build the cave wall, and very soon, as you'll see, the cave roof, without building the interior of the cave, because you can't see a bloody thing. It's super dark, and the lighting goes super strong and super heavy on the contrast, and it makes it impossible to work with. So I kind of tried for a long time. You'll see how bright that is. You're going to get blinded a lot in this video, I'm afraid to tell you. I kind of tried to make it work. It just wasn't going to happen. I don't know why I tried. Just don't put the roof on. Don't put the walls in. Just build the interior, then add everything else later on. And I did come to that conclusion. It just took me a little bit of time, unfortunately. So here I'm just trying to get sort of the height of the roof right. The idea is, if you think back to that caiman habitat we did, if you saw my video on that, there's like this hole in the roof and then shafts of light, of moonlight, spilling into light up the cave below. This is the general idea. This one is going to have a much bigger hole in the roof and a hole on the left hand side as well, which is where the staff members will be entering in. But yeah, this whole period here is just me just trying to figure out how on earth I'm going to make this happen. I was close to just thinking this is not going to work, but there we go. That's how you make it work. You kill everything. And we're going to work on the interior looking something like this instead. There we go. Just destroy the world and get to work. This is how I should have started in retrospect. So there's going to be a lot of rocks. It is a cave after all, but the rocks are going to be very heavily interspersed with foliage. And we're going to have like a little bit of a river as well that sort of careens in from the right and then goes underground to the left hand side. Something like that, basically. Just trying to get the edge of the water right, making sure constantly to check that my water, the river, where the boat ride is, that's going to still be okay, because when you can't refill the river, you'll never get it back. You have to keep checking to make sure that you've still got the water capabilities that you want. And it seems okay. It seems okay even now, so we are good. So basically, yeah, river on the right, and then it's going to be this sort of staggered, sloping area on the left-hand side, a lot of it in staggered sort of step-looking rocks. A lot of the rocks is in steps sort of thing. Natural steps, but still steps. And then there's sort of a little bit of a ramp, which I'm hoping the leopards will be able to navigate. Now, I haven't brought the leopards in yet. We're going to do that together at the end of this video. I don't know how it's going to turn out. This is a very, very, very crowded habitat with lots of rocks and quite a lot of foliage by the end. So whether the leopards will be able to navigate it, we'll have to wait and see. But my main focus for this, I would say, was, you know me and my rocks. it was about making the rock. Oh, excuse me, I'm dying. At least I went now doing what I loved, placing rocks. It really was making the rock formations feel as natural as humanly possible. And that's very much sort of what the basal inspiration was that and fancy lights. You know, rocks, I may love rocks, but I love lights just as much. And it was nice to bring that in again. This exhibit does look horrendous in the daytime, but you're not allowed to see it at daytime. You have to see it at nighttime. That's when it's, that's what it's made for. And, you know, I've got like a new sign. I'm going to show you stuff as well. This whole area is called the Lost Caves or something. I kind of want like a less cliche name, but I've already kind of built the sign. So anyways, so what I like to do is build the basic shape in terrain, as you can see, and then you start adding the rocks. And that means you've got a bit of a base to work on, and it means where the ground pokes in is sort of natural. So you see, wherever there's like a step in the ground, you put the rock in and kind of in the step. If you imagine a step, right, it's like this sort of shape, right? Where's my mouse? There, so it goes like this, 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 this. Okay, that's a step. The rock goes in this bit here, in the vertical part of the step, right? That's my tips. I wanted to bring in some different rock, though. near enough by the water. I don't know why, for some reason in my head, mossy doesn't go near the water, and the other rocks go near the water. That's just kind of, you know, again, no realism, just vibes. It's about committing to an idea and sticking to it. It doesn't matter, you know, you're trying to build a consistent in-universe world more than an actual world. That's the way I see it. But we couldn't just do mossy rocks that way. It would get a little bit boring. I really wish, more than anything, I wish I could scale. I'm not going to lie. Every time I play the game now, I'm like, oh, it'd be nice if we could scale these rocks, wouldn't it? My life would be 1,000 times easier. It really would. But hey, the rocks are still kind of nice, and you can build some pretty cool things. You do have a lot of creative control. It just takes time, more than anything else. Although this wasn't a humongous build. Probably 2 hours, 45 minutes, something like that. I did do some work off camera, mainly because my recording program decided to stop for some reason at the end. So I did lose a little bit, but I'll show you all that during the tour anyway. As we put more rocks down. There's not much for me to say about this process. I do have a real image that I'm basing this on. It's definitely not one-to-one or anything like that. It's just an approximate kind of thing. Just so, again, I have an idea for how the rocks in this environment would gather naturally. Because, again, we're going for, I wanted realistic rock formations. And the idea is it is an underground, rocky, forest, cave kind of shebang. This was the point where I realized my first problem, however. And this is now my biggest request in Planet Zoo for sandbox mode, is to have either the ability for animals to never break out, as in they will never cross the boundary even if it's a null barrier. Alternatively, a null barrier that does act as an actual fence, essentially. So either a setting that says animals don't break out, or another null barrier that does still act as an actual fence. Because I have this exhibit that I really like, and I was going to put a fence at the front if I wanted to do a little one, but it has to be 3 meters tall or the leopards are going to get out. It's really annoying. And it's sandbox. I feel like we should be able to do what we want, so that's definitely high on my request list now. Bringing in some of the habitat stuff nice and early. We kind of flew through this bit, didn't we? Oh, and there's my football. every time I tabbed out to change my music on the other screen, I don't think Planet Zoo has like a windowed mode, or at least it wasn't working for me. So I had to tap out, and then I had to go change my music, and you get to see my BBC Sport homepage. How exciting for all of you, I know. More rocks. More rocks. Oh, and some moss. I didn't go too hard on moss. I'm not a big fan of carpet moss. It's too bulky, I guess, is the word. It's too 3D. You know, if you had some nice moss that kind of sat on top of things, which you can kind of do with it, that would be chill, but it's a little bit too blobby for my liking. More rocks. One day we'll move on from the rocks, I promise. Checking the water levels, making sure that still works. Now it's time for the foliage. This was hard work, because in some ways, I didn't want to go too hard on the foliage because I wanted you to see the formation, I wanted you to see the rocks. I wanted it to be possible for the leopards to navigate the area. On the other hand, it is meant to feel like an underground, like a really lush underground cave, part rainforest. And I really struggled with this for a long time. Like here, it was looking okay, but nothing special. And then I started using a new plant, which I'll point out when we get there, and it kind of brought the whole thing together in a way. I framed the whole thing really nicely. Because at this point, I still wasn't happy with it. I was just kind of, you see me clicking tons of different plants here just to try to figure out what on earth it is I want to include onto the habitat. And then I just, you know, we'll just go back and put some more rocks in instead. Oh, I really wish, this is a side note, but the mossy rock does not have a non-mossy equivalent. None of the rocks in the game are the same colour as the mossy rock. If you imagine the mossy rock without moss, there isn't a rock that's equivalent to that, which is kind of a pain as well, so it'd be nice if we get something like that. Not a big deal, though. Not a big deal. I was waiting for my foliage moment. Kind of just... One thing I like about this is we have a very specific frame, which is right here. This is the only view you're ever going to get of this habitat as the boat goes past, so we can angle everything and build the entire habitat with that very much in mind. You know, we can shoot it like a photograph, and that's our frame, and we just fill it to make that frame as interesting looking as possible. Here we're just doing a little bit of work on the slope. You can see this kind of slope down here in the middle. I don't know if the leopards can navigate it. I'll have to look at it in-game when we get there. Bringing in the hyacinths, I don't know if this is how they would be used in real life, but I also don't care because they look cool. That's really the important thing. They look good, and that is what matters. Bringing in some rocks. I like having plants kind of circling around the rocks. It just feels natural to me for some reason. Could have brought in water lilies as well, but I was in a hyacinth kind of mood. You know, some days you wake up, you think, I feel like a hyacinth today. So you make yourself a hyacinth. It's the dream, honestly. Working on my little pointy out rock. Never really ended up looking normal, but it was there in the image. So I thought, alright, pointy out rock. It's a real rock. It exists. Pointy rock deserves love as well, basically. And bringing in some more foliage colourings. It's nice to have some variations. So if you're going to sink a plant into the ground to make it into foliage, bring in a couple more, and then you get this nice little sort of differentiation in colour. It was starting to come together at this point, but then... Where is it? Where's my realisation? Where is it? Any second now. I'm pretty sure it's on the way. No, just killing time as I try to think about what on earth I'm going to do. And then no, a bit of Scaevola. What was it called? Scaevola? Scaevola? Scaevola bushes. I used to hate them. I've grown on them a little bit. And then... Wait, there it is. The first time I've ever used these lipstick palm trees. And they were a revelation. They were perfect. They created this really nice sort of frame. I'm going to say the word frame. Frame is the new thematic. Around the ramp part. Basically, they've got a really nice burst of colour and a colour that's sort of thematically appropriate for the Southeast Asian zoo that we're already making. Decided to push the foliage a little bit heavier, make it just feel a little bit more dense, and that's really, that and the lipstick palms around there is really what kind of brought this habitat together for me. Ended up being pretty happy with it. And this is when I realised, yes, the leopard needs 3 metres. Fortunately, you can barely see the fence. When we bring the lighting in, like I said, this is going to be viewed at night time. The glass essentially disappears because there's no light on it. I was very careful by the end to make sure there's no light on the glass. Because then you can basically look through it. It's like it's not even there. Save it up. Going to build up that roof again. Put a big old hole in it. There we go. So we're going to have a nice light shaft coming through there. I'll try to show you the image. It's a beautiful shot of this sort of misty, overgrown cave. We need to add mist as well. That's what we'll do after this video when we get in game. And there's like moonlight coming through and it's blue, but it's also like got shades of orange to it and like sort of yellowish colours. And I want to bring all that variation of colour coming in through this light shaft. It's honestly beautiful stuff. I don't know what we're doing after this. The plan was to do gharials, and that also kind of has a light shaft, so I don't know if I want to do that so soon. It might feel a little bit repetitive, but we'll see how that goes. Oh, the whole area gets super dark as well, which is really cool. You see, it's, yeah, there we go. So very much the same technique we used last time. We used the big spotlights here. These create these really dramatic shafts of light that you can see right there. Gorgeous stuff. Honestly, the lighting in this game is spectacular. If nothing else, the lighting in this game is so good. And I wanted both to have it. This one on the left is going to be a little bit lighter. You know, again, the light is kind of bursting through at the end of the tunnel, this light shaft in the cave. But I wanted the top one to be stronger and more impressive because that's, you know, directly below the moon. Yeah. I love it. It looks so good. This light shaft makes me so happy. I just want to work with light shafts all day. Nothing else. I don't need other things. I just need lights. I did go a little hard on the lights. Initially, I've tempered them a little bit since then. Unfortunately, a couple of them, like I got rid of all of these, a couple of them are kind of hidden in the ground and I can't find them anymore. Always keep all your lights in a group because you will hide them under rocks sometimes and you'll never find them again, folks. So all these lights here that we've got, these green ones, it's a little bit too intense. So they all get changed to like a soft blue, and then I'm going to lower those later on as well. Just because I'm kind of in two minds. I want you to be able to see the leopards wandering around the habitat, so there has to be lights in the habitat. Otherwise, all you'll have is a shaft of light and you'll never see the actual animals. But on the other hand, I want the shaft of light, the sort of the moon hole, as we shall now call it, I wanted the moon hole to be really impressive and to stand out and to be bright and evocative and thematic, all these words. And if the whole exhibit is lit up, I think it loses some impact. So it was quite tough to find a sort of a middle ground between the two, but I think we got there at the end. Like I say, it will be, I've done a little bit work, little bit of work since this video, so it should be, I think, nigh on perfect. That's the one I lose, right? Where is it? It's there. It's just in front of that rock. Okay. That one, I've been trying to find that goddamn spotlight for absolutely ages, because it ruins, it's too harsh, and the lighting ruins my tone. And this is me trying to track it down right now. Right, and then this little sort of shaft of orange. I don't know what my in-universe explanation for this would be, but light comes in various tones, and maybe it's just, I don't know. I don't really know, but I really liked the colour. Maybe the wall is just a bit more yellow or something, but the combination of the orange and the blue was really nice. So I thought we'll run with it, basically. Yeah, a little bit, you can tell it's a little bit too late, but we'll be fixing that. By the end, not to panic, folk, not to panic. That's nearly English. It's just me trying to find out. It's in there somewhere, but I could not for the life of me dig it out. Like, I'd rip up the entire world, and I just still couldn't find the bloody thing. Not without getting rid of all the rocks in the process, which I don't really want to do, so kind of just going to have to deal with it for now. Right, so I had a couple ideas for this back wall. Initially, you'll see what we're doing here. We're going to build, like, a little stone thing. And the idea was basically this is, you know, as you go past, you can look to the right and see the animals, you can look to the left, and that will be the info board for our clouded leopard. But again, I kind of don't want to pull attention away from the right. You're not in here for very long, you know, it's a big exhibit, but your view of it is quite short. It's only this little segment of the river, so I didn't really want to pull attention away from the right hand side. So I'm going to build all this and then I'm going to get rid of it. Here, I was trying to cover the cave with a little bit of ground. Also, this thing. I don't know, I have to try to hide this mammoth cave bulge I've created. Anyways, yeah, so I was trying to sort of cover it with a little bit of dirt to A, blend in with the stupid rocks I've already put in, but B, because I wanted to make it darker, if possible, and it just wasn't really working. I don't know what it is that makes, I don't know how the light in this game works, because this could be completely surrounded by dirt and it still isn't as dark as the main cave. I think it's a height thing. I think I would have to put a layer of dirt much higher than this, above the sort of snaking part of the cave. You see how darker it is as soon as you get in there? And it isn't just because of the lights, it is actually darker. I was trying to do it, but it just wasn't taking, so it still looks okay, but I would have liked it to all have that sort of pitch black kind of look to it. And there's our clouded leopard sign. Now, like I say, we will be getting rid of this. We'll be moving that sign over somewhere else, but I'll show you that nice and close in-game. I'm really happy with how these signs have turned out. I've built about 6 or 7 now custom sign designs for this park, all themed around the same color schemes and holding items and all this kind of jazz, and yeah, they look really nice. Like, I should be a professional, I'm just saying. Well, I used to be fair, but that's neither here nor there. I'll show you it smaller in game, but we're going to do typical, there's my music. That's my old school playlist. We're going to end up moving it off the left wall and building a smaller one on the right hand side instead. Basically, just so, you know, like a typical info board you'd have on an exhibit, because this is still meant to be a zoo, and there it is right there. Okay, apparently that's the end. So I have done quite a lot since that video. We'll hop in, I'll show you all that. We're going to bring in the leopards. I've just punched my headset. We're going to bring in the leopards, and we're going to bring in some mist as well. Not too much, I'm going to try to keep it light, but I think it needs a little bit of mist going around. So I shall see you folks in a second. Okay, we're going to start here at the entrance, just because I have made some minor changes. You'll see we have a new welcome sign that I built. This is actually two signs together to make one, a big old sign. So we have our welcome sign there. My boat tour sign has been slightly adapted in terms of colour. I mentioned that the font was not quite in the right place. And I've changed the colour of all the entrance stuff just to make it, you know, yellow and green. It's kind of the yellow-green dashes of orange and red are kind of the theme for the park. So that's the noise it makes. And you're going along, And there's a little sign here on the right, so this is my new sign. As you can see, now entering the Lost Caves. There's my little custom sign. So the background image you can see there is the image I based this on in the first place. And I'll show you this very quickly, because I'm low-key proud of all this. So if I change this to SE Asia logo, you'll see how it's similar. You know, the box shape is there, this shape is there. Although, you know, this needs moving position-wise, I've really just noticed. The background's changed, but I've kind of brought in a different colour scheme and, you know, some of the cave kind of goes over the top of the painting. So the point is it should feel as the same as one big part of it. Does it make sense? It should feel like one big whole, but it mixes things up because it's a whole new section, essentially. And I need to change this back to Malay. There we go. So there's the Malay version as well. I just decided to go with Malay because Malay is the language that the park name is in, so we're going to kind of lean with that for the entire thing. Anyways, that's clearly too close to the top. I will fix that. But still, now entering the Lost Caves. I'm very proud of this, by the way. You're going forward. You're round the corner. There's mist everywhere. There actually should be more mist. It'll start to pop in, I think. Lots more lights. These little fires poking up. The mist starts to seep in, as you can see. There's a little boat there. Abandoned, ominous red glow. And you head inside the Smilodon's mouth. I was thinking about having a little sign here saying, you know, keep your hands and keep your limbs inside the vehicle, and then you're going along. And this isn't something much to this, it is just these little torches. I was also considering maybe writing a short story, a very short story, about the clouded leopards and how they came to live in this underground forested cave, and then every time you go past one of these, you'd have another segment of the story. My concern with that is simply that you wouldn't have enough time to read it, so what I'm thinking is we might wait until the custom audio is in the game, and I can actually just record myself saying it, so as you go through, you'll be able to hear the story. Something like that. I might put some signs up. I don't know if I mind this bit being a bit boring. It's meant to build suspense, you know? You don't have to throw things at people every 5 seconds. Anyways, so you kind of just go through the cave. Around the corner, obviously that eventually won't be there, that'll be nice and dark. And we enter the habitat. That's your first glimpse. Ooh, there's my clouded leopard sign right there, so you can see it. Oh wait, I fixed this. Did I not save it? I mustn't have saved it. Today, I did fix that. So, there's my clouded leopard. With little info facts and dietary requirements and this text over it, blah 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 blah. And I cut his little ears out, so he sticks out, you see? It's good, isn't it? And you're going forward, and there is our completed habitat, basically. So you can see I've toned down the lights a lot. I would love to tone this one down as well, but I just can't seem to do it. The only other thing I'm considering is maybe this plant is a little bit too in the way, now that I look at it. I think it's really important that I maintain the sight... I don't know. That sight line gets kept, but it's kind of there. It's kind of there. Soften that light down there a little bit as well, and yeah, there's our underground forested cave, I suppose. Not much to add to it other than this, folks. Basically done. At all. Is there somewhere? There it is. Okay, click it. That'd be nice. Okay, let's have a little look at this nav mesh. So good. Get down there, get down all around here. Can get down to that bit somehow. Can't really get down to this entire area over here. That would be nice to fix. And apparently, this is outside of the boundaries of the habitat. Surprises me slightly. I'll have to change that. I think I can just move the boundary habitat, basically. Is that really outside the boundary of the habitat? That's okay, I don't mind that. Otherwise, the mist is just so bright, you know? Even in the dark, it's super bright. What's that look like there? It's super bright, and it doesn't seem to take into account the colour, so it only looks good on the blue of the water. So I think that's basically as far as we're going to go with that. But I really want to get rid of this light. But I love the light shaft, and it looks like a cave, and... As I say, you can't really see the boundary. Like, the glass doesn't have any lights on it at all. I was very specific about that. Let's just fix that nice and quick. It does mean it's slightly difficult to see your leopards. I won't pretend otherwise. They're not easy to spot, generally speaking. Especially when they want to hang out over here. This is like the only place I don't want them to hang out in. Let's go over here. The exhibit is substantially bigger than I expected as well. Look at that! Amazing. Hey, doing, buddy? Who are you? What's your name? This is King, Queen, Queen Swing? I don't know how you pronounce it. King? Quing? Quai? Quang? Maybe? Quing? Quang? I don't know. Just chilling? Licking yourself? There's one flying down from the sky over there. It sounds negative. They aren't really the focus of this habitat, you know? They're never going to go hang out under the light shaft, for example. But if we take our boat past, obviously you can't see the boat quite yet, we need the finish line for the boat. Yeah, you're not really going to see them, are you? You'd have to have a pair of binoculars, but I think I'm okay with that. I like that. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I will find out a way to get them down here. I will work on that on my own time to get them down right here at the bottom, or at least down, yeah, in that sort of rough area. Should not be impossible. Hello, buddy. How you doing? I guess because they're going to hang out over here so much, I might have to do some detail work over here. An area that I've largely neglected at this point in time. What are you doing? Okay. So they come hang out on the... Where are you going? Yes! Ignore the flying spotlight, okay? Maybe I did get rid of some of them, but... I mean, you can't really see them from here. It kind of just blends into the rock. It does look a little silly, but... Unfortunately, every time I try to take a nice screenshot, it means looking up into the hole, which means you see everything. All the nonsense I have up there. Including this nonsense. I'm not big on nonsense. Actually, I love nonsense, but nonsense must be destroyed. Oh, hello. I'm going to bring in some more of them. I'm going to try to do a little bit of a better job hiding these, but I mean, I don't think we have to. At the end of the day, it's a zoo, right? It would have lights that are visible, so I'm not too worried about that. The point is, from here, it looks like I would want it to, and then you'd have to, you'd have to zoom in and take a look at things, but yeah, I'm pretty happy. Okay, right, we're going to end it there. I've prattled on for far too long already. So I am considering some text here, as I've said, but I'm not 100% sure. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Next video, I think it's going to be the Gharial, because it has to be part of the boat tour. So I'll let you in on the plan, right? This is secret. Shh. I really like the idea of you being on a boat tour in the water, and then for you to look to the side and in the cave... through the glass, there's more water. So it's like a staggered level of water. So there'd be water like... So you imagine this was filled... Like the glass was up there, and this was filled with water. That's the general idea. So it's a gharial enclosure you exhibit... You see entirely from underwater. Yeah, you see the underwater part of the exhibit whilst you're on the water kind of thing, right? Gonna be kind of inspired by, like the blue holes you see from, you see them from above, and it's like this pit in the ocean that descends down. So it's gonna be very similar to this, which is what's concerning me, but I'm thinking like an underground ruin kind of thing, and then it's all underwater, and then this beam of like pure blue light like streams in and illuminates this entire underground world. And I think we can maybe bring in the billboards a little bit as a backdrop, but I'm not too sure. And then after that, the boat tour will end. We're going to go on land, and it's going to be our Binturong habitat. So, plans are in motion. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. If you did enjoy this build, please do hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the little bell icon next to the subscribe button. Thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.